Am I audible to all of you? Yes,
Yes,
ma'am.
ma'am.
Is the screen visible?
Yes, ma'am.
We were doing sums on hedging in futures. So how do we do hedging? How many contracts to buy to avoid the risk while we do hedging? We'll continue with the same sums and we'll finish them today so that tomorrow we can start with the new concept or the new chapter. So let's see, we'll do this sum. Most of you have the question paper, so if you have it, you can go to the paper. Otherwise, I have typed the question here for better understanding. You can also look at the question here itself. Can anybody confirm, have we done this sum earlier? As far as I believe, we have not done, but still check in your books if possible that have we done it. Till then, I'll read the question for you. On March 1, 2011, an investor has a portfolio of five banks. Bank shares as given here. So there is Axis Bank, Bank of Baroda, Bank of India, Canara Bank, and Corporation Bank. All the details are given. The cost of capital is 12.5%. They've asked you to calculate the theoretical value of the CNX Bank index. If its current value is this much, futures have a minimum trade lot of 20 units. Obtain the number of contracts of CNX index futures he needs to sell in order to get a full hedge until May for his portfolio. Assume that the futures are trading at their fair value. Anybody has checked? Have we done this sum?
No, ma'am, we are not done.
Ma'am.
Okay. So first thing is we will calculate the portfolio beta. Then we'll calculate all other things. So to do the portfolio beta, these are the columns that we require. Okay. The bank names, price of the security, number of shares. When we multiply the price with the number of shares, we'll get the value. So when I do 1,298 into 1,000, the value is 12,98,000. Similar way, we will multiply all these values and we'll get the value of the contract. Once you get the value of the contract, we can find the weightage. To find the weightage, what we need to do, first we need to total the value. So we'll add all this. This is the total of the contract. Now to find the weightage, I have to do value of Axis Bank divided by the total. You'll get the weightage of Axis Bank. Same way, value of Bank of Baroda divided by the total. I hope you all remember how we have found the value. Value is equal to price into number of shares. Okay, so using that formula, we found the value. Now we have to find the weightage, which is nothing but the value of particular bank divided by the total. So how are we going to do that? Axis Bank value divided by the total, you will get the weightage of Axis Bank. Similar way, Bank of Baroda, the value divided by the total, you will get the weightage of Bank of Baroda. We continue in the same manner and get the weightages for all. Now, because I'm doing it in the Excel sheet, I'm getting all the digits. If you're doing it on the calculator, I've told you after the decimal, you can consider four digits. Okay, I can also reduce it to four digits like this. So this is what is the weightages that you get. Once you get the weightages, you can multiply the weightage with the beta to get the portfolio beta. So the formula is weight into beta, you'll get the portfolio beta. Okay, so we multiply the weightage into the beta to get the portfolio beta. Now we'll total it so that we get the portfolio beta. So the portfolio beta is 0.7880. So this is how we calculate the beta value. I'll just copy this table in the Word document. So we'll show this solution. First thing that we did was working note on how to calculate the beta. I hope it is clear till here. We have done lots of sums on this in the class as well. Anybody having any doubts? Any doubts, anybody?
No, ma'am.
So this is the first thing that I did. Now what they have said, just see, the cost of capital of the investor is 12.5%. So R is equals to 12.5%. Then calculate the theoretical value of CNX Bank index futures for May 2011. So they want you to calculate F naught. Theoretical value is nothing but your calculated value. So we need to find this, and we need to find it for May. Okay, so May means from when the contract has started. It has started on 1st March, and we have to find the value for May 2011. So March, April, May, 3 months we have to consider. In March, we have 31 days. Plus April we have 30 days and May we have 31 days. So that will be equal to 92 days. So time we are going to consider as 92 days. Then we'll see what else is given there. If its current value is 10,770, so that means it is your S naught. The current value is 10,770. And CNX Bank Index Futures have a minimum trade lot of 20 units. So S naught will be 10,770 into 20 units. So how much we get? 10,770 into 20 if I do.
$2,15,400.
Okay, so this is the spot value. Now we can find F naught with all this data, but here our R value is not continuously compounded. So the first step is to find R2. So to find R2, the formula is M, which we consider it as 1, into natural log of ln 1 plus R1, that is 0.125, 12.5% divided by M, which is again 1 because they have not told the compounding frequency. So your R2 will be equal to, just see the natural log of 1, it will be 1 into natural log of 1.125. 12.5% is, so 1.125 is natural log, you see. Anybody? How much do you get, anybody?
1177, ma'am.
1177 into 100, if you do, it is 11.77%. Now we can find the value of S naught. So F naught is equals to the basic formula, S naught into e raised to RT. So we have to do e raised to RT. Okay, So it is raised to, I've taken it up if you could see. So F naught is equals to S naught. F naught is equals to S naught 2,15,400 into E raised to RT. So E raised to R is 0.1177 into time you have calculated it as 92 days. So 92 divided by 365. This has to be raised to. So E raised to that value. So you will get F naught is equals to. Anybody just see, calculate.
Two lakh twenty-one thousand eight eighty-five point nine seven.
If I take four digits, I have got 2,21,871. So, depending on how many digits you are taking, the answers will change. I've told you always. So, we'll take it as 862. This is the value of F naught. Now, see here what all they have asked. We have finished calculating this. Calculate the theoretical value of CNX Bank Index Futures for May 2011. So till May 2011, this is the theoretical value of the index. Then obtain the number of contracts CNX Index Future he needs to sell in order to get full hedge until May for his portfolio. Assume that the futures are trading at its fair value. So now we have to find the number of contracts until May. So the formula for number of contracts we will write down. Is equals to value of portfolio requiring hedging divided by future value. We need to divide this first and then multiply it with the portfolio beta. So into am I audible? Am I audible to all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
So we have to use this formula for hedging and we have to calculate the number of contracts. So let's put all the values in the formula and do it. So number of contracts is equal to value of portfolio requiring hedging that you found out in this table, the total value of your portfolio, which is 68,25,250. So we'll take that 68,25,250 divided by future value or future contract value, you can say. Now future contract value, if you see here, you have calculated the futures value 2,21,862, and in the last line of the question also they told you, assume that the futures are trading at their fair price. Fair price is nothing but your calculated price. Remember during arbitrage we have done actual future price and fair future price. So this is the calculated price and you have calculated to be 2,21,862. Divide it with that 2,21,862 and multiply it with the portfolio beta value which is calculated here 0.7880. So multiply it with the portfolio beta. So you get the number of contracts. Just see how much you get. 24.24. Anybody else got any other answer? Vishal, Vinpal and Prajakta, all three have got 24.24. So majority of you, I guess, have got this answer. Approximately 25 contracts the company will buy. So this was the question. Any doubts with anything in this question, anybody? Is it clear for everyone? Should we go to the next question? I have calculated both the things, the theoretical value of the contract, and if we do a full hedge. Full hedge means full contract is hedged. That means 100%. Okay. And I have taught you in my previous class, if 130% is hedged, we'll do value of portfolio into 130. If 80% is hedged, we'll do value of portfolio into 80%. So depending on whatever percentage is hedged, the formula will have to change a little bit. Okay. Any doubts? Should I go to the next term? Please confirm. Should we go to the next term?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. The next question is from the paper, December 13, Jan 14. If you have the paper, you can take it out. Question number 5C, 08 NBA code. On Jan 1, 2003, an investor has a portfolio of 5 shares given below. So A to E are the 5 shares. Just check one of you also that have we done this sum, because I was not sure. Okay, so A to E, the prices are given, number of shares are given, and the beta of the portfolio is given. Cost of capital to the investor is 12.5%. And they have asked us to calculate the beta of the portfolio, theoretical value of the Nifty futures for February, if its current value is 1005. So we need beta, we need the theoretical value, and lastly, we need to also find the number of future contracts the investor should trade. Okay, so let's start with first with finding the portfolio beta, for which I'll do it in the Excel first so that it is easy for me to find the totals there. So we'll calculate the portfolio beta here. Anybody has checked? Have we done that sum?
No, ma'am, not done.
So draw this table. Suppose you're not able to draw, or if you're not doing it along with me, because if you feel I'm fast, I'll share this with you, the solutions. But if you're able to do it, it will be good, because you'll copy it down and it will be easy for you to study later. So just see if you can do it along with me. Value is, anybody can tell me how to find the value? Price into?
Price into number of shares.
Price into number of shares. Okay, so find the weightage and then beta and portfolio beta. So first we'll do price into number of shares. So company A, price is 59.5 into the number of shares 5,000. So you get 2,97,500. Similarly, for all the companies, we can find 81.85 into 8,000 is 6,54,800. 101.1 into 10,000 is 10,11,000. And so on. We'll total this value so that we can find our weightages. Add all these values, you get the total of the value 40,51,300. Now to find the weightage, you should see the value of company A and divide it by the total. Same way for B, value divided by total. So equal to the weightage is value of company A divided by the total. You get the weightage. Similarly, equal to value of company B divided by the weightage, company C divided by weightage. And that's company E divided by weightage. So you get the value. Just take 4 digits after the decimal. Now to find the portfolio beta, we have to do the weight that we have found out into the beta value. So we can do equal to weightage into the beta value. You get the value of portfolio beta. Drag it. Only 4 digits I'll take. We need to total it to find the total portfolio beta value. It is 0.7662. Anybody else has got any other answers? I hope you are writing it down along with me, and I hope all of you will get the same answer. This is done it on Excel, so the chances of calculation error are very less. Okay. So first question I have answered, calculating the portfolio beta, the beta of the portfolio. Second is theoretical value of the Nifty futures for February. So we need to find F naught. Theoretical value they have said. If not, this question mark. Okay. They've told till February. So the contract has started. We see the beginning on Jan 1st, and we need to find it till February. Nifty futures for February. So the time will be 31 days of January plus we take 28 days of February. We don't know whether it's a leap year or what year. We will not fall into it. We'll just do 31 days of Jan and 28 days of February. So that comes to 59 days. This is the time. Now they've given you R is equal to 12.5%, which is not a continuously compounded rate. So first we need to find the continuous compounded rate. In the previous sum also the R value was 12.5. And we found the continuous compounded rate. So I'll just take it from there only because the R value is same. We'll get the continuous compounded rate also to be same. 11.77% will get it after we do. So we'll not do it again because same rate. 1 year compounding if we do, it's 11.77%. Now we need the spot price, that is S naught of the contract. Look at the question here. In the third point, they said if its current value is 1005 and the Nifty futures have a minimum trade lot requirement of 200 units. So its S naught is 1005 into 200 units. So we need to find what is S naught. 1005 into 200, if I do it, is 1000. 2,01,000 is S naught value. Now we can find the future value, that is find the F naught. F naught is equals to S naught 2,01,000 into E raised to RT. R is 0.1177 and time we have taken 59 days, 59 divided by 365. So this is how we will use it in the formula. This is as a raise to E raised to this much value. Okay, so let's calculate F naught equals to, see if anybody can find the value.
204,859 is what I have got. Just check if anybody else is trying. 59.60. I've taken four digits and done. Okay, Vishal has got 204,860. Fine. Shubham 204,86. Soumya 204,859, 865. So all are close to the answer. If you take four digits after the decimal, you will get 859. Okay, so you can take this as future value, whatever you have got. Now let's see what next they have asked us to calculate. So we have finished the portfolio beta. We have finished the first two questions are over. Okay, then obtain the number. Obtain the number of contracts of Nifty he needs to sell in order to get a full hedge until February for his portfolio. We need to find this, and they have told assume the futures are trading at their fair value. That means we have to take what is the value that we have calculated. This is the fair value. They have not given the market value. We have to take our own value and solve for number of contracts. Number of contracts to hedge this full portfolio until February. So the formula was value of the contract requiring hedging. So this is the value of the portfolio that requires hedging. 40,51,300 is our portfolio value. 40,51,300 divided by value of the future contract. Here is calculated 204,859.60. We need to divide these two and then multiply it with portfolio beta. Increase the font size. I hope it is visible properly. Okay, we'll see what is the portfolio beta. 0.7662 is what we have found. 0.7662. Let's calculate and see. Divided by
15.15.
Okay. Anybody else? Yes. All of you are getting the same answer. The number of contracts equals to 15.15. Okay, so this is the third question. Yes, everybody is doing it. So good. Shweta, Kirti, Mitali, Dipali, Rajapta, Vishal, Twinkle, Soumya, all of you have got the same answer. That means we are doing it correctly. Okay, so we have solved the third question also. Now let's see what is the fourth question. Calculate the number of future contracts that investors should trade if he desires to reduce the beta of his portfolio to 0.7. So for this, I told you the formula will change a little bit. This is the original formula. Okay, this is the formula. Now what we do is whatever beta we have calculated, we minus from that the given portfolio beta. So we call it PB dash. Maybe and just put the inverted comma there instead of dash. So portfolio beta, what we have calculated, minus the new portfolio beta that is given. Okay, so let's see how much we get. Value of portfolio, number of contracts is equals to this value of portfolio requiring hedging, 40,51,300 divided by value of the future contract, which is 204,859.60 into the portfolio beta that we have calculated, 0.7662 minus the value which they have given. It needs to be reduced to 0.7. So 0.7 is we are minusing. Now see the number of contracts. 0.309 Shubham has got. Any other answer? Anybody else? Any other answer? Just check. Twinkle is also got the same. So two people have confirmed. Jyoti is also got the same. Okay. So this is the answer. Value of number of contracts after we reduce the beta. So everybody is getting the same. Correct, Vinanti. Kirti has done it. I hope all of you are following and we are going with the same speed that we do in the class. And so these were the two questions on how the index future has to be valued. Now let's go to the next question. It's a little different. Mitali has also got it. Now this is a little different from what we are doing till now. Here is the question. I hope all of you have completed the previous sum. Going to the next question. Consider the following data relating to KM stock. This is not there in the question paper. So I'll be sharing this Word document with you. So you can write it down. The question can be written down later. Solution, if you want, you can copy it now along with me. Okay, and leave some lines to write down the question. Or later you can take a printout, whatever you feel convenient. Better to write it down. Okay, consider the following data relating to KM stock. KM has a beta of 0.7 with Nifty. Just 1 minute. Each Nifty contract is equal to 200 units. KM now quotes at rupees 150 and the Nifty futures are 1400 index points. You expect prices to fall and have gone short 1200 shares of KM in the spot market. Now first question, how many future contracts you will have to take? See here, I'll just write down whatever is given first so that I can make you understand the question. They have given you the beta of KM stock, that is 0.7. Okay. Then they have given you each Nifty contract is equal to 200 units. Okay, KM now quotes at rupees 150. So they have given you the price per share. You can say X naught of KM, which is 150. And the Nifty futures are 1400 index points. So this is S naught for Nifty. The given stock value also, as well as the index value, 1400 into, we know the lot size of the index, that is 200 units. So we can do 1400 into 200. So we get 280,000 as the index value. Okay, then what they have given, KM now quotes at 150 index, okay. You expect price to fall and have gone short 1200 shares of KM in the spot market. So what you have done in the spot market, that is today market, you have gone short means what? What is short position? Anybody? You can type.
Huh? Sell, ma'am.
Sell. So you have sold. Okay, today's market you have sold KM stock. And how much we have sold? 1200 shares. Okay, so we have sold 1200 shares today. This much is the data that they have given. Now let's see what all they are asking. Again, I am repeating. They are talking about one share as well as the Nifty. The share beta is 0.7. Price per share today is 150. Nifty value today is 280,000, 1400 points into 200. And today, KM stocks are being sold for 1200 shares of KM stock has been sold by the investor. First question, how many future contracts you will have to take? To find the number of contracts, the formula is value of portfolio requiring hedging divided by future contract value into portfolio beta. Okay, so we use this formula and find the number of contracts. Number of contracts Now, value of portfolio requiring hedging means we need to know how much is the price per share today for KM. 150 is the price per share today, and we know that we have sold 1200 shares. So, in our today's portfolio, we have 150 rupees per share and 1200 shares of KM. So, this is our current portfolio. Okay, I'm writing it here. It's 1200 are shares and 150 is the price per share today. So, this is the value of the portfolio requiring hedging or the current value of your portfolio. Any doubts in this, anybody? Okay, divided by the future value of the contract. Now, we know only this future value of the contract, that is 2,80,000. So, we are going to take the same because there is no other value which is given and there is no hour or time given that we can find F0. So, whatever is the current value, index value, 1400 into 200 shares, we will take that itself as the future value of the contract. And we will multiply this with the portfolio beta. We don't have the portfolio beta, but we have beta of the KM share, which is 0.7. We cannot find the portfolio beta because we don't have all the shares that are there in the index. They are only talking about one share. So we are finding the number of contracts only for that one single share of KM. Any doubts in this formula, anybody? We can solve this and find the number of contracts. Yes, Shubham, it is 0.45 contracts. This is nothing but approximately one contract. 0.44, 0.4499, 0.45. So this is the answer. So first question, Dipali has also got it. So it is how many future contracts you will have to take? We'll have to take these many future contracts. That means we'll have to take at least one future contract. You don't get it in fractions or decimals. Okay, let's see the second question now. Suppose the price in the spot market drops by 10%, how are you protected? Now all of you with me, today we have sold 1200 shares of KM. And we have also taken one contract, one futures contract to hedge the portfolio. That means to avoid the risk. So I'm repeating it again. Hedging is nothing but taking two opposite positions in two different markets. So in today's market, I am a seller. I have sold KM stock today. This is highlighted. And in the future market, I have bought one contract. 0.45 contract means at least one contract we have taken. So here I am buying and here I have sold. So I have taken two opposite positions. That means I have done hedging. Now I have to show how I am protected doing the hedging. So first question, sorry, second question. Suppose the price in the spot market drops by 10%, how are you protected? So let's see what happens if the price drops. I am solving the second question and I write it here. Price drops by 10%. How are we protected? We have to show. If the price drops by 10%, today's price, the spot market we are doing, spot market, we'll find the new price. The price was 150 and they are telling the price has dropped by 10%, so I will minus 10% of 150. That means 15 rupees. 10% of 150 if I find out. So 150 minus 15 if I do. Can you tell me what is the new price then in the market? 135, correct? 135. So this is the value or the price of the share today if the price drops by 10%. Now what we have done in today's market, we have sold one at rupees 150, right? So just see here. All of you with me, I hope, and finding what we have done today. So I have sold shares for rupees 150 and I have sold 1200 shares. So 150 into 1200 if I do.
1,80,000.
1,80,000 is what I have sold now. okay. From this I will minus what is the new price now, okay. So the new price is 135 into 1200. Okay, 135 into 1200 is
1,62,000.
Okay, so that will be 1,80,000 minus 1,62,000.
18,000.
18,000.
That is your gain. See here, I'm repeating it again. They're saying the price drops by 10%. You have sold. If the price drops by 10%, the new price will be 135. You have already sold for 150. So you have gained 1,80,000 from that minus. What would be the new price? So I have sold for 1,80,000, but now the market price has become 1,32,000. Okay, so 1,80,000 minus 1,32,000. My gain is 18,000 in today's market. Is that fine? Now we'll see what is happening in the future market, okay? Future market. You have bought one future contract. See, the number of contracts that you got was 0.45. You can't buy it in fractions. So if it is 0.45, we'll round it off and we'll buy one contract, okay? So bought one futures contract. 4 rupees. For how much we have bought the futures contract? ₹1,400 was the index into 1,400 into 200 is the lot size. So 2,80,000. So 2,80,000 is the lot size. Any doubts still here? Clear till here? You bought one future contract for ₹1,400 into 200 lot size. So 2,80,000. ₹2,80,000 you have invested in the future contract. Is that clear, all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Now they are telling that the market has dropped. The second point we are solving, price drops by 10%. When the price drops by 10%, that means the index value also will drop by 10%. If the index value drops by 10%, you will have a loss of 10% means 1400 if they are index points. Minus 10% of 1400. So you will get the new index points as 1400 minus 140 if I do.
1260, ma'am.
Yeah, 1260 are the new index points into the lot size was 200. So your today's value is, instead of loss here you write price drop value.
2,52,000, ma'am.
2,52,000.
Yes, ma'am.
So what, see here all of you, you have invested 2,80,000 in the contract. Now the contract has become 2,52,000. Remember, in the future market we have bought, I'm highlighting this, we have bought one future contract. I have bought it for 2,80,000, but today the value has become 2,52,000. So whether I'll gain or I will lose, you bought it for 2,80,000 and now the value has become 2,52,000. You gaining or you're losing? Yes, anybody?
Losing, ma'am.
Losing. So you are at a loss. Loss of how much? 2,80,000 minus 2,52,000.
28,000.
28,000 is the loss. See here, all of you. In the today's market, you gain 18,000. In the future market, on the contract, you lose 28,000. So your net gain or loss is plus 18,000 which you gained minus 28,000 which you lost. So how much is the net loss? Minus 10,000. Is it clear? Only this problem is like this, where they're actually asking you to show how it will work, and it is not tough. Remember what I have done. If the price drops by 10%, today we have bought the shares, so I have bought it for 150, and the price is, sorry, I have sold shares today. I have sold it for 150, and the price has become 135. So I will gain, how much I will gain? 1,80,000 minus 1,32,000, 18,000 I will gain.
Ma'am, it's 1,62,000.
1,80,000
minus 1,62,000.
62 it is?
Yes, ma'am.
So 18,000 you will gain. Then in the future market, here you have sold in today's market. So in future, you will have to buy. So you have bought one future contract by investing 2,80,000. Index also has dropped down by 10%. So the index has become 1,260 points into 200. You bought for 2,80,000, index has become 2,52,000. So you lose 28,000. So today's market, you have gained 18. Future market, you have lost 28. So your net loss is 10,000. So by hedging, you have reduced your loss to 10,000. Is that okay? The third question, suppose the price in the spot market jumps by 5%, what happens? Instead of dropping, now it is jumping up, means it is increasing. So in the third question, price jumps by 5%. We'll do the same thing. So what we are doing today, sell the shares for rupees 150, and we are selling 1200 shares, so 150 into 1200, which we did here, 1,80,000. Now the price increases by 5%. So the new price will be equal to 150 plus 5% of 150. So see how much you get new price?
7.5.
So it will be 157.5. Correct? So
yes, ma'am.
Yeah. New price value will be 157.5 into 1200 shares, which is equal to, just see, 157.5
1,89,000.
Now see here, all of you, you have sold the shares for 1,80,000 and the new price has become 1,89,000. So how much is your loss? 1,80,000 we have sold minus
1,89,000
is the new value that is there in the market. So you have sold it for 1,80,000, but the market is now giving you 1,89,000. So your loss is 9,000 in today's market. Now let's see what happens in the future market. You bought a futures contract, same here, bought one futures for 1400 points into 200 is the lot size. Okay. Now the new price. So instead of price drop, we have price increase. Price jump. Okay. So 1400 plus, it has jumped, means it has increased. 5% of 1400. So how much you get, just see. 1400 plus 5% of 1400?
70.
So it will be 1470, the new value, into 200. $2,94,000. So now you will gain here you have bought the index, future index at 2 lakh 80, and now it has become 2 lakh 94. That means you have bought it at a less cost. So now you will gain how much?
14,000.
14,000 is your gain. So your net gain or loss in the spot market, you lost 9,000. So minus 9,000. And in today's, in the future market, you gained plus 14,000. Minus 9 plus 14?
Plus 5,000.
Plus 5,000 is your gain. So if the price increases, you will gain 5,000. If the price decreases, you will lose 10,000. So this is how the market will perform. Okay? So this was a different type of a sum. So I've just solved it. In one of the very old question papers, it was asked. I've done that. Any doubts here, anybody? In my next class, we will discuss theory, or the remaining theory, and depending on that, this is one sum where we have to find minimum variance hedge ratio. So in my slides, I have the formula for it. How that formula works, we will do it using this sum in tomorrow's class. Okay. As of now, I'll take attendance. And then you can leave. I'll just call your name. If you're there, you tell me present or absent. And tell your friends that I'm taking attendance in this manner. So if you are not there, leaving the class in between or anything such, then it will be difficult. Okay, when I started the class, we were 31. Now we are 30. Two logins are mine only. That means you're 28. Okay, so today is 6, that's 3. Abhishek, Amit, if you're, you cannot unmute your mic, at least type in the chat box present when I call your name. Okay, so I'll check their roles. Akshata? Amit?
Ma'am, which Akshata?
Akshata Halgannawar.
Ma'am, no, I'm Akshata Bagri.
Okay. Amit? Deepali?
Present, ma'am.
Divya? Okay, let's do this. Instead of doing all this, you type your name and USN on the chat box. Anyways, I'm recording. That will get recorded and I'll mark your attendance. All of you type your name and USN in the chat box. After typing your name and USN, you can leave the meeting. Yes, after typing, you can leave the meeting. Type your names in the chat box and leave the meeting. Hema and Mantesh, have you typed your names?